أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين وأفضل الصلاة وأتم التسليم على رسوله الكريم وعلى آله الطيبين الطاهرين وعلى أصحابه الغر الميامين ومن تبعهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين اللهم اجعلنا منهم اللهم علمنا ما ينفعنا وانفعنا بما علمتنا وزدنا علما وعملا متقبلا برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين. We begin, as we always do, by first and foremost praising Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, thanking Him, acknowledging that He is the only one worthy and deserving of all praise and thanks. And we ask Him to shower His most complete and abundant blessings and protection upon His noble Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, upon His noble family, upon His shining companions, and upon all of those that follow them until the end of time. And we ask Allah to include us from amongst them. We ask Allah to teach us what will benefit us, to benefit us through what He has taught us, and to increase us in knowledge and accepted actions. Ameen. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah. Welcome to the middle portion of IOK's 30 in 30 Journey Through Suratul Mulk series. I hope you all have been having a wonderful and productive Ramadan so far. The middle 10 days of Ramadan can sometimes be a bit interesting because this is the part of the month wherein people usually start to lose their steam a little bit and become complacent with what they already have done. The first 10 days, everyone is excited and ready to go, and the last 10 days, everyone is excited and ready to end. So before we begin our material today, I just wanted to take a moment to remind all of us to keep going. Keep pushing through and take advantage of the entirety of this beautiful month. Today we are exploring verse number 11 from Suratul Mulk. Allah says, أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم فاعترفوا بذنبهم فسحقا لأصحاب السعير. So then they acknowledge their sins. Away with the people of the blaze. This verse is a continuation from verse number 6, wherein Allah describes the evil, awful destination that is the punishment for those who disbelieved in Allah. Allah described that they will be cast into the fire, hearing the fire's deafening and thundering roar. The fire is so intense that it is boiling over and almost bursting apart from rage. And every time a group of people is cast into that fire, the keepers of that fire, the guardians of that fire ask, "Didn't a warner come to you?" They respond, "Yes, a warner did come to us, but we disbelieved. If only we believed, listened, and used our brains, we would not be from the people of this blazing inferno." And then we arrive at this verse here. So then they acknowledged, confessed, admitted, owned up to their own sins. Away, distant be the people of the blaze. These individuals of the fire acknowledged their sins and wrongdoing when they were already in hell. They recognized that what they did was wrong when it was already too late. If they had recognized their wrongdoing in this life, then perhaps they would not be in that same position of being inhabitants of the fire. If they realized and recognized their sins while they still had time left in this world, they would have had the chance to turn back to Allah, to repent, rectify their lives, and protect themselves from such an outcome. But they didn't. They realized, man, the way I lived my life was so wrong. They realized that when it was already too late. This verse serves as a huge wake-up call to all of us. We do not want to be among those people on the Day of Judgment, in the hereafter, that recognize our errors and faults when it is too late to do anything about it. On the Day of Judgment, in the hereafter, is not the time when we want to be saying, regretfully, "I should have done better. If only I listened, if only I used my brain, I would not be here right now." If you are watching this video right now, alhamdulillah, Allah has blessed you with life. He has allowed you to live, to breathe, and to exist in this world. And as long as you are alive, this is the time to acknowledge our mistakes and rectify our affairs. This is the time, right now, to take a hard look at our actions and behaviors and ask ourselves, Is this something that makes Allah happy or angry? Is this something that will help me or harm me in the hereafter? Is this something that will cause me delight or regret on the Day of Judgment? Now is the time to recognize in what areas our lives need improvement. We have the time right now. We have the opportunity right now. So long as we are alive and breathing, we have the chance to protect ourselves from an awful outcome in the hereafter. All we have to do is, firstly, take that time to think, ponder, and reflect. Assess our situation and recognize the problem areas that need to be fixed. Then, once we acknowledge and realize the wrong that we may have been engaged in, we must repent. We must turn back to Allah, discontinue our wrongs, feel remorseful, and make a firm determination to never return to those sins again. Then we must strive to rectify and fix our lives, live lives of repentance and dedication to the obedience of Allah. We should all do that now when we are alive and have the chance. We shouldn't wait until it's too late to recognize the wrongs in our lives. Many of us have experienced guilt or remorse in this life, specifically for not taking advantage of our time. Whether we are parents, regretting not having spent more time with our children when they were young, whether we are in the workforce, regretting not having spent more time studying in school, whether we are playing in a sports competition, regretting not having spent more time practicing. We have all experienced regret when it comes to matters of this life and not taking advantage of time. And we all know that regret, guilt, remorse, they are not nice feelings to have. It feels icky. It is an emotion that we all try to avoid. But the regret of the hereafter is nothing like we can even begin to fully understand. The regret we feel in this life over not taking advantage of our time is relatively temporary, refers to small amounts of time. The 4 years of college, the first 10 years of a child's life, the 6 months leading up to a competition. But imagine regretting your entire life. Imagine being on the Day of Judgment and thinking to yourself and telling the angels around you, the guardians of hell, "Man, I really just wasted my entire life. The entire 70, 80, 90 years I had on this earth, I just completely blew the whole thing." May Allah protect us from ever feeling that way. We do not want to have that type of regret in the hereafter. We do not want to be among those people that this verse is talking about. Those people that recognize and realize their sins when it is already too late. So take advantage of the time that you have right now. Reassess your actions and behavior. Reevaluate your priorities. If we do all of that now, while we are still blessed with time and life, we can do what we are able to earn Allah's mercy and secure a spot for ourselves in the highest levels of Jannah. So again, our verse for today is, فَاعْتَرَفُوا بِذَنْبِهِمْ فَسُحْقًا لِأَصْحَابِ السَّعِيرِ. So then they acknowledged their sins. Away with the people of the blaze. May Allah allow us to take advantage of our time in this life and use our lives to earn His mercy, forgiveness, and paradise. Ameen. وَصَلِ اللَّهُمَّ عَلَى خَيْرِ خَلْقِكَ مُحَمَّدٍ وَالْحَمْدُ لِلَّهِ رَبِّ الْعَالَمِينَ وَالسَّلَامُ عَلَيْكُمْ وَرَحْمَةُ اللَّهِ.